Seasonal quarantine day two. It's gonna be so easy. I can read all day. I can stay in my room and no one is going to say, why don't you go out? Why don't you see your friends? You need more friends. Joke's on you. Who's going to survive for weeks on their own without talking to anyone? Me. Who couldn't care less about keeping in touch with a single one of their friends? Me again. I wish I can quarantine for the rest of my life. It's gonna be easy. Quarantine. Day eight. So, things are fine. You know, it's one thing to say it's gonna be easy to stay in the house when you have the choice to stay in the house. It's a much different kind of baloney when you can't. I actually don't enjoy reading all day. All day. A particular concept, until you actually sat and stared at the same page for hours and hours, and I've done things. I alphabetized my books, rearranged my posters into themes, made the clothing donation pile, which is still a pile because I can't take it anywhere, rearranged my posters, and made 7 dioramas. In my spare time. What am I going to do tomorrow? Scenes from quarantine. Day 149. Or 7. The situation is dire. My parents have retreated to the separate areas of the house because of the my meeting is more important than your meeting clash at 10 a.m., which is followed by the 8 a.m. clash of why are you wasting toilet paper? Which follows by the 7:56 a.m. That was in 20 seconds exchange. No.
Can you believe it?
I miss you so much.
Well, as much as I miss you.
I miss you more. I can't believe it. Quarantined.
Only they waited one more day for a stay-at-home order. We could have been married.
On together.
Oh, this rotten luck. Still, we're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
We're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
Did you get my present? I sent a messenger to your house.
Yes, I got it. Aren't we lucky messengers are considered essential services? Did you get my present?
I did, and I disinfected it thoroughly.
If you didn't have to do that, I'm not sick.
Never know.
I do.
You could be asymptomatic. You could have touched something.
I'm not sick.
You're pretty absent-minded. You could have touched something without realizing.
Is that right?
You sound testy.
That's because I am. Still, we're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
We're healthy and well, and this is for the best. You didn't have to get me a present.
I wanted to. You're the very first boy I ever bought a present for. I hardly knew what I was doing. Nobody teaches you how to buy presents for the very first boy you ever bought a present for, especially when you're not supposed to be thinking about boys at all. You're just supposed to be happy with the one your parents throw you at. Nurse taught me a lot of things, but present shopping wasn't one of them.
You did fine. I'll even go to say that you did perfect.
Perfect? That's a lot of pressure. This present has to be right. This present is a representation of our relationship. If I got the wrong gift, that means my feelings were false.
No. I know your feelings are true because I can feel them all the way from your room to mine.
Aw, Romeo, are you happy with the present you bought?
Totally. I got the absolutely best present. I am an awesome gift giver if I do say so myself.
Sounds like you do.
It was a little tricky because we've only been dating for a day, but I'm not worried.
Oh, good.
Shall I open yours? Ooh, nice wrapping. I love the paper. We have to save that. Whoa, so much tape. Next time, I'll show you how to only use 3 pieces. You'll be surprised how little you need. It's incredibly satisfying to use these tiny, teeny little squares and be able to wrap something like a tennis racket.
Just open it. Open it. Open it. Please. Oh.
Oh.
You hate it?
No, no.
The socks.
I can see that.
You talked about always having cold feet. Oh, I screwed everything up.
Relax. It was your first time. I've had more practice. Open mine.
Okay.
Aren't you gonna admire the wrapping?
Nice wrapping?
I only used 3 pieces of tape.
A hairbrush. You got me a hairbrush?
This hairbrush is specifically designed to get the tangles out of your hair, your type of hair, with the least amount of breakage. It has a non-slip ergonomic angle handle with a balanced load distribution to that of your wrist, which will always be in the exact right position. A work of art and a work of science. It's beautiful. I had it engraved with the family crest.
Yes, you did. Can I ask you a question? I want to clarify something.
You want to learn? I'm touched.
Because you're so much better at gifts. A hairbrush is better than socks.
It has your family crest.
Everything that I own has my family crest.
This is a good present. Sorry? This situation is tense for all of us. We're healthy and well, and this is for the best.
The socks are way better.
How dare you?
100 lambs died to get you in the wall for those socks. They need to wet because I made her redo it, the pattern, 3 times. This is a mark of a fine present. Choose with love and care so you can suck it, Romeo Montague.
I'm not sure I can wear socks Lime died for. I'll hear the death bleating when I walk.
You're impossible.
You are.
You are.
You.
I need social distancing.
You're in your house. How much distance do you need? Maybe we don't really know each other.
Maybe we shouldn't buy presents for each other.
Yeah, but I do have an idea for your birthday.
What now?
You don't understand. Things are different now. I wish you hadn't come, Miss Douglas. I have to look after my brothers. There's nothing to talk about. We don't have a computer, and our internet never works. You could leave a packet of assignments of you if you want. I won't be doing them. I told you, I have to look after my brothers. Have a good life, as much as you can these days. There's nothing to... You don't... Stop! Stop talking! Nothing you say matters. Don't you get it? It's all gone. Everything I planned for. Graduate, work at the diner until the very last second, pack my life up and escape. Gone. No school, no job, and maybe no college. I have nowhere to go. I can't leave, even if I wanted to. I am here. You better go. I have to look after my brothers.
Don't touch your face. Don't touch your face. Don't do it.
How about you don't touch your face?
Oh, I won't. I don't want to.
Really?
Not at all.
Not at all? Really? The itching isn't driving you crazy?
I won't let it.
Oh.
I understand the severity of our situation.
Well.
We must be diligent.
Right.
Don't you think so?
Sure. Especially when I have friends like you who keep on reminding me.
These are unprecedented times. I feel I was made to rise to the occasion under these circumstances of difficulty and strife. I was made to answer the call. Can't you feel responsibility coursing through your veins to stand and be in this moment more than you could ever as a human being?
Fine. I don't want to touch my face. I can't wait to be a better human being.
Oh, good.
Nope. 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 How can you stand this? I never realized how much I touch my face, scratch my nose, rub my eyes. I'm a walking disease factor, you know? Actually, I'm a powder puff of plague. Nope. I feel like I'm a hotbed of infection.
All it takes is a little self-control. I'm surprised you can't find it within yourself to dig deep and wrestle your weaknesses. We almost do better, Ren.
You just touched your face.
What?
You scratched your cheek.
I did not.
Yes, you did. Yeah, you did.
So what if I did? I wash my hands every 15 minutes. I wipe down every surface and doorknob on the hour. I'm totally germ-free. I've got everything under control.
You've got weaknesses like the rest of us.
Ugh.
Today's gonna be a good day. No, we must wrestle our weaknesses or gently live with them.
Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
I know you're breathing. I can hear you.
Come on to the open.
Fine. Hello?
You...
Surprise!
You're not welcome here. Get out.
Come on now. Aren't you pleased to see me, not even a little?
Why would I be pleased to see the thing responsible for a global pandemic?
Stop, you're making me blush.
Why would I be pleased to see a disease in my home?
Disease is such an ugly word. You can call me Co. It's short for COVID-19.
I know what it's short for.
Yeah, not the name I would have chosen, but it does seem to be on everyone's lips these days. I'm everywhere. Still, I do prefer the short form. You can call me that.
I'm not calling you anything. We're not friends.
I mean, we could be. We could be best friends.
Stop where you are. Get back. Back.
You're not being very nice. It's a pretty fabulous friend.
Pass.
Is this how you treat someone who's been invited into your home?
I didn't invite you.
Alex, you did.
I did not.
Last week when you snuck out.
Shut up.
Come on now. I'm not going to tell. I'm your friend. I want you to raise your fist and feel you're being mistreated by this quarantine. It's awful. I can't believe that I'm trustless. We can totally do social distancing. Resist and break the rules all you want. Push for things to be they were yesterday, last month, last year. Because when you do, we need to sneak out and go to a party where there are lots of people to talk to and things to touch. It's rather lovely. You're lovely.
But we were careful.
I'm sure you were.
We were. And no one there was sick.
I'm sure they weren't. Not visibly, anyway.
Well, I wanted to see my friends, you know, face to face. I miss them.
Oh, and I appreciate that feeling. That's a thank you. You make my job easy.
Crap.
You may not think much of me now, but we're going to have a lot of time to get to know each other. Well, not a lot of time, but we're going to become great friends. The very best, you'll see.
Oh, we're here. That was sudden.
Oh, no.
Why can't we choose our own groups?
Okay, so we have 10 minutes and then we'll be pulled back into the main room. Our instructions are...
We're not actually working, right?
No.
What?
This class doesn't matter. She can't make us do anything.
We get marks for showing up. We can talk about whatever.
How surprising.
What shows are you watching?
Just like class. You do the bare minimum and I end up doing everything. Ugh, losers.
Hey!
What did you say?
You heard me, and I'll say it again. Losers, both of you.
You wouldn't dare say that to my face.
Wouldn't I? Let's try it. You are a waste of space.
Isn't this an overreaction for wanting to talk about Netflix?
Work or don't work, your slow descent into a useless life is none of my business.
What happened to you?
Just wait till we're at school. Just you wait. I'm going to-
Oh, stop it. You're not.
Are you telling me what to do?
Yes. What happened?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Did you lose someone? Is someone sick?
Is that the only thing that would make you care?
Why is it that when some people find their voice, it's so annoying? You never talk like this. What happened? Is it your parents?
No. My parents are doctors.
Oh.
Where?
St. Joe's. I've barely seen them in weeks. They can't keep up. They try, but there's no end. They're not saying anything, but it's written all over their faces. It makes me feel... I can't. There's a constant lump in my throat, and I feel...
Like death is at the door.
Yes, and knocking loudly.
That's rough.
So you know it's hopeless. All of this? Giving us assignments and trying to pretend that school has any point anymore.
But I want it to have a point. I want to do something that feels normal. And besides, you acted this way before the world went kablooey.
I guess. But now it's different. Everything is hopeless and we are lost.
Sometimes it feels like that. It's hard to fight.
You have to. You have to fight because we're not lost. We're here. You're alive. You can't let this drag you under. Hope is stronger than hopelessness. Always has been. Always will. I know it doesn't feel like that right now, but it's temporary. Just don't let go of hope.
That's a lot coming from someone who's here for the marks.
I just want to talk. My parents have decided to handle this by working 18 hours a day in silence.
My mom isn't doing well. She won't talk either.
I'm worried about my grandmother. She's alone.
Yeah, so maybe you can talk about movies or food or music?
Something normal?
Please.
I hate eggplant. Slimy.
I hate eggplant too. My mom deep fries it and it doesn't help. Ugh, disgusting.
I'm against all vegetables. My mother tries to make smoothies and pretends that she didn't put vegetables in.
Mine too.
My grandmother doesn't hide them. She just stares at me till my guilt can't take it anymore.
There's a signal for Misty. Was that good?
It was. Thank you.
Look, you can't stop me. I made up my mind. I've thought about this for a long time. What else do I have to do? This is my decision, and you'll have to respect it. I'm gonna cut my hair. I'm gonna do it, and whatever happens, happens. I'll live with it, because I can't live with this. This is driving me mental. Look at it, look, you know I'm right. I understand that some may feel that hairdressers are not an essential service right now, but I'm here to tell you, they are dead wrong. It is essential that I have someone deal with this. And now we're back to the essential, non-essential argument, which no one is going to solve. So it's up to me. I'm the one. I must raise a pair of scissors and deal with consequences. I understand that some feel this decision is not important. There are larger issues the world is dealing with, but good hair has a place in this world. Okay, I'm gonna do it. Don't try and stop me. Here we go. Wish me luck.
The human is still here. The human is still here. Why is the human here?
What? Huh?
Why is the human still here?
Isn't it great? It's so great. Great.
Useless. The human always goes away during the day, and now they're not going anywhere. They haven't left the couch in 3 days.
Our human goes places. We go for walks. It's so great. Great.
Useless. I am not talking about your pointless meanderings. How am I supposed to properly reign with the human constantly underfoot demanding snuggles? I don't have time to snuggle during the day. I must survey my domain. This is disrupting my order. We have to find out why.
Why what?
Why the human is still here.
Isn't it great? It's so great. Great.
Useless.
This is the best time of my life.
You think every time is the best time of your life. 5 minutes from now is the best time of your life. We must return order, Lucky. We can't let this go on. Let me think.
Hey. Shadow. I got something to tell you. It's really important. Really.
What? What is it?
Our human is here all the time. Isn't it great? I wonder why.
Useless. The human is always busy. Always on the go. That was the strategy from the beginning. Keep the human busy so that I may reign in peace. Something must have happened out there.
Out where?
Outside.
Outside? Huh. It looks pretty much the same to me.
But it's not. It can't be. Because nothing is the same. The human keeps looking at me and talking to me and expecting snuggles. Order has been lost. This isn't normal.
Maybe things will never be normal.
What?
Not like we know them. Maybe this is going to change our lives forever. And we'll have to figure it out. And we will. And our humans will. That's what humans do. They may whine a little bit, but then they roll up their sleeves and go on. We always go on.
Lucky, did you just speak deeply?
What? Huh? Right?
Useless.
Have you ever said something out loud? Like in conversation, where you were trying to sound funny or trying to be controversial, or you just wanted to sound, I don't know, hostile for fun? No, spiky, like a hedgehog, only cool, a cool hedgehog. Did you know baby hedgehogs are called hoglets? They are so cute. Did you ever want to have an aura of chaos for a few seconds? Have a hostile adventure? You know, just a short one? Have you ever wanted to be steeped in unrest? even though you're actually pretty quiet, rather peaceful, and enjoy a good book on a Friday night. Who knew we'd have all this time to read? If people feel you're steeped in unrest, you become cool. Doesn't anyone want that for a few seconds? And I did it for more than a few seconds. I can't wait till we have an apocalypse. The world is going to hell anyway. Better sooner than later. And when it happens, and it will happen, I'm going to live by my own rules. No one can tell you what to do when chaos takes over the world. No, when disorder is the law of the land. People would ask me to say that last bit in the halls. When disorder is the law of the land. Yeah, so here we are. Chaos, the world, me. Saying something and it actually happening are two vastly different things. I discovered I'm rather fond of rules and order and going to school. I don't want a hostile adventure. And I feel like this is all my fault. Cause I wish so hard for it to happen. I take it back. I'm sorry. I take it all back, okay?
Is this on? Are we on?
I can see and hear you.
Great. Famine, turn your mic on.
This is going to take forever.
What are you in a rush for? Isn't your part done?
I'm monitoring the situation. There are a lot of moving pieces. It's a scenario that needs constant attention.
Uh-huh.
Besides, maybe I have something else. Maybe I have a date.
Do you?
No, but I could.
Okay.
I can end the world and date at the same time, you know. I'm an excellent multitasker.
Turn your mic on.
Hello? Can you hear me?
We got you.
This is the 21st century. Why don't you know how to work a computer?
Why aren't we meeting in person?
Death can't make it in person.
Death can't make it for 5 minutes. I was really looking forward to brunch.
You could take 5 minutes to learn how to work a computer.
If you're gonna start on me, I'll go. I got other things to do.
What's everybody rushing for?
Just because you're not front and center per usual.
Are you saying I'm jealous of a global pandemic?
If the shoe fits.
Ridiculous.
All I'm saying is someone is not getting Employee of the Year this year. And someone is totally gonna get it.
Where is Death?
I don't... Ah, in the waiting room. Just, let me click.
Yes. No. Yes. Alright, no. If they're going to push.
Hey, Death?
No, absolutely not, Jennifer. Tell him, absolutely not. It won't be long. Did you send the report to my email? Great, thank you. Hey, gang, how goes the battle?
Awesome.
You have a secretary?
Administrative assistant.
Why don't I have a secretary?
I wish I had two. Speaking of, can we speed this along?
I call to order this meeting of the four horsemen of the apocalypse. Yes, I see your hand. Can I get through the call to order first?
Why do I have to keep bringing this up? It's the 21st century.
We are aware.
We're not all men. And when was the last time any of us were on a horse?
It's the name of the organization. Take it up with someone of a higher pay grade. Talk to HR. All right. The agenda for this meeting.
I didn't get an agenda.
I didn't get one either.
Did you send it to Jennifer?
I'm hungry.
I didn't actually write up an agenda. I didn't think we needed it.
Well, I wish you would have written one up.
I wish I had a BLT.
There's only one thing to talk about. It's the only thing anyone is talking about.
Still, you could have taken 5 minutes. It's not like you're busy or anything.
Laura's happening. Laura's always happening. Just because you're getting all the brownie points right now because of a jacked up flu.
Ooh, you are jealous.
I am not.
You don't see me getting all bent out of shape because famine didn't get any brownie points.
If war fess up, you're looking a little green.
Can we get going? Death and pestilence, give your reports.
I'll go. Oh man, guys. I gotta go. I just got an alert. The beaches are open in Florida. I'll have Jennifer shoot you a copy of my report.
My turn. I don't think I need to point this out, but I will. Things are going great. Better than great. This pandemic is over the top amazing.
Why don't you shoot me your report too? I'm gonna go make a sandwich.
But you always want to hear war's reports. Unfair. I deserve to be part of the agenda. I deserve to be heard. I'm going to write you all up for this, in triplicate.
Well, that was a waste of time. Not that I have much to do right now, but I'm not jealous. I wonder if I could start a war in Iceland.
I am slowly going crazy. 1, 2... 3, 4, 5, 6. Switch. Crazy going slowly, am I? 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch. My dad asks how I am every day. He's involved. Always checking in. I say fine. Fine, Dan. Thanks for asking. Doing okay. It's easier to say fine than explain. Because I should be fine. I should be. I don't have a lot to be unfine about, other than quarantine, a virus killing people, and the possible collapse of the economy. I should be fine. Everyone I know is healthy. My parents didn't lose their jobs. There are more than enough rooms in our house for everyone to have all the personal space they need. I have my own laptop. The internet's great. See what I mean? I have everything to feel fine about and productive. I should be so productive right now. I could practice my guitar, and how many times have I said I wanted to be better at Spanish? Now's the time. Now's the perfect time to become the best version of myself. I'm not doing anything. I'm not fine. I'm heavy. It takes forever to decide what to wear in the morning. Poor Dorian. You feel bad? Poor you, living in your big house with everything you could ever want. See what I mean? I can't tell anyone about this. How my arms feel like lead. My feet are trapped in cement. And the weight is pulling me down. I can't breathe or see daylight anymore. I haven't seen it for weeks. How do I say that to my dad? Why do I feel so sad when I have everything?
Wow, look at your house. That is such an awesome floor. They're doing such cool things with laminate these days.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm inviting myself in, of course. You've been outside. You haven't worn gloves or a mask. That lady coughs and touches the door and get in the head. Haven't even properly introduced myself yet. Poor planning on my part. I'm Co, short for COVID-19. Not the name I would have chosen, but we do what we can.
You can't come in.
Sure I can. I'm in right now. I'm on you. Did you know that? It's like we're best friends. That's how close we are. It's only a matter of time before we get even closer.
I haven't touched anything. I haven't touched my face.
It's only a matter of time.
Not if I wash my hands.
But why would you do that?
It's the first thing I do when I get in.
Seems obsessive.
I don't want to be your best friend. In fact, you interrupted me, so...
Not so fast, not so fast. Before I leave, let's talk. Let's chat. Confab with the COVID. You don't need to wash those hands right away.
You're here, so I really do.
I'm just kidding. I'm not that bad.
Millions would say otherwise.
Can't help it if I'm popular.
Then you should go and talk to those people.
No, they don't count. I want to get to know you.
Prepare to be disappointed.
All right. Wash your hands. See if I care.
Done.
Wait a minute.
Sure. No, I'm washing my hands, and I'm washing you out of here immediately.
You'll be sorry. I have so many awesome jokes. I have a ton of interesting stories. I am a pretty fabulous friend.
You kill people.
That is an unfortunate side effect.
Out now.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Not a happy birthday, anything but a happy birthday. I hate that song.
Happy birthday to you.
Since we're quarantined, day who knows? Wednesday, Thursday, soup day. Who knew the days of the week would be the first to go? Canceled, just like everything else. I went for a walk today. To nowhere, really. I couldn't stay in my room anymore. There's this girl that's on my street who's on my calculus class. We never talked before. We're not in the same circles. But today... Hi, how are you doing? Okay. Some days I'm okay. Ups and downs. Me too. They canceled prom.
They did?
Yeah, they did. That sucks. I bought a dress. When is this gonna end? I don't know. No one does. It sucks. Yeah, it does. Conversation. Who knew I would have enjoyed that? The sun is still shining. I'm glad it still does that. Thank you.